Residential School. And let's do this. The feds have confirmed that hundreds of arson after Kamloops mass grave claims. The Trudeau Liberals stated that hundreds of fires at places of worship nationwide were the result of intentional arson sparked by baseless claims of mass graves at Kamloops Indian Residential School. The Trudeau government confirmed hundreds of fires at places of worship nationwide were caused by arson attacks by unsubstantiated claims of mass graves at Kamloops Indian Residential School. Data was drawn from police reports compiled by Statistics Canada. Quote, this includes incidents that occurred on the surrounding property, such as an attached cemetery or adjacent parking lot inside religious institution or building, Cabinet wrote in inquiry of ministry tabled in the Commons. The figures were tabled at the request of the Conservative MP Mark Dalton, who asked, what are the statistics related in incident of burning places of worship, end quote. The inquiry encountered 423 police reports incidents at places of worship since 2015. The Year of Truth and Reconciliation Commission published a report claiming 4,100 children died at residential school. Arson attacks averaged as few as 13 a year before the report, according to Blacklock's reporter. Police counted 90 arson attacks in 2021, the same year that the Kamloops Suwepemec First Nation of Kamloops discovered 215 alleged graves. No remains have been unearthed at the Kamloops site, with investigations to take upwards of two decades to complete. The First Nation received a $7.9 million federal grant for this field work, but later revised their claimed 215 remains to some 200 potential burials. An incident map showed at least 96 churches had been destroyed, burned, vandalized in Canada since the spring of 2021. On June 21st, 2021, an unidentified of people burning down St. Gregory Church located on the reserve land near Soyuz, BC, the second church to perish that day on Indigenous land. Hours earlier, the Sacred Heart Church on the Penticton Indian Band Reserve also burned to the ground. No charges were ever laid in those respective fires. A Soyuz Indian Band Chief Clarence Lewis, who expressed grievances with the Catholic Church, told CBC News he had suspicion about who may have been responsible. Quote, I was upset that some res punks did arson, said Louis. I don't think white people came here to burn this down, end quote. At the outset, many Indigenous leaders quickly condemned the unresolved anger that perspired into unwarranted, unimaginary destruction. To burn things down is not our way, said National Chief of Assembly of First Nations there, Perry Bellegarde. Our way is to build relationships and come together, end quote. Quote, the destruction of places of worship is unacceptable and it must stop, added Prime Minister Justin Trudeau. The inquiry noted arson attacks on places of worship included an undisclosed number of incidents targeting non-Christian institutions. Quote, institutions include churches, synagogues, temples, mosaics, and exclude cemeteries not physically located on the religious property, said the inquiry. According to CBC News analyst, 24 of 33 church fires since May 2021 were deliberately set. Only two have been ruled an accident, while seven others remained under investigation at the time of publication. About half the fires involved in Catholic churches, but include over Christian sectors. 14 fires took place on First Nation reserves, while 13 others happened in rural towns or hamlets. Last December 15th, Wood Buffalo police responded to a devastating church fire in Janvar, Alberta, a hamlet adjacent to Chipewyan Prairie First Nations. Alberta RCMP investigated the fire for foul play. The fire follows a separate RCMP probe into two fires at Barhead churches last December. Investigators believe those blazes were intentionally set. Last May, the Commons voted unanimously to consider measures to coordinate the protection of faith communities. It followed a Justice Committee task force proposing the appointment of an anti-hate crime task force. Without freedom of religion, without freedom of movement, without freedom of speech, there actually is no freedom in this country, Conservative MP Melissa Landsman told the Justice Committee. No parliament committee to date has examined arson attacks on places of worship. An Ottawa think tank, the McDonnell Laurier Institute, published a May 5th commentary identifying reluctance to discuss the crimes. Quote, these sacred places are more than just a place to worship, said the commentary. The woke silence over church burnings is deafening. They help to create a sense of community, places where families and friends gather to celebrate and to mourn. Canadians have been extremely reluctant to comment on the crimes, said the commentary.